Within the nation of South Africa, there are a vast series of dark-colored mountains which span all the way to sections of Eswatini and Lesotho. These darker regions are colored that way by abundant volcanic rock which generated a mass extinction event during the early Jurassic period. As 183 million years ago, what is now the nation of South Africa was the site of numerous incredibly voluminous effusive eruptions where, in only a few years' time, 5,000 cubic kilometers of lava would coat an area the size of the nation of Cyprus, with lobes of lava filling valleys and riverbeds it encountered along the way, traveling as much as 500 kilometers distant. Such eruptions repeatedly occurred over the next 1 million years, with one similarly sized eruption occurring every 500 years during this brief geologic time span. By the time this flood of basaltic lava had ceased erupting, a total of 3 million square kilometers of land had been coated in dozens to hundreds of layers thick of volcanic rock, totaling 1,500 meters thick in some areas. What had just formed were the Karoo flood basalts, which also erupted in what is now Namibia, Botswana, and Zimbabwe, along with the Falkland Islands and eastern Antarctica. However, due to erosion, over the next more than 100 million years, some of these flood basalt-related rocks would go on to form a spectacular array of rock pillars. What I'm referring to is the so-called Valley of Desolation, which is located 47 kilometers east-northeast of Aberdeen on the very southern edge of this ancient volcanic plateau. These pillars stand at up to 120 meters or 394 feet above the surrounding landscape, and due to their sheer 90-degree vertical cliffs, provide for a fascinating geologic oddity. These hundreds of vertical pillars are composed out of a rock type known as Diabase. Diabase is a rock type which is considered subvolcanic, meaning it formed beneath the surface at fairly shallow depths. To help understand this, if basaltic composition magma solidified as hard rock at a depth of greater than 2 kilometers in the crust, it would form a rock type with fairly large crystals referred to as Gabbro. On the other hand, if the same composition magma solidified as hard rock at a depth ranging from 2 kilometers deep to just below the surface, it would have formed a rock type known as Diabase, which contains smaller crystals. And if the same magma had erupted onto the surface, it would have produced the rock type known as Basalt. All three of these igneous rocks contain the same composition, but where they were in place created the differing varieties of rock. However, the story of the Valley of Desolation in fact began 100 million years earlier during the Permian period than when the Jurassic Karoo flood basalts erupted when this section of South Africa was just outside the Antarctic Circle. In this wet and temperate environment, numerous lakes developed, causing small mud particles to build up over time, creating a rock type known as mudstone. Eventually, some of the same mud lithified and turned into a rock type known as shale. The climate eventually got warmer, and layers of sand piled up in meandering rivers which crossed the Permian environment. This sand eventually became compacted, forming a layer of sandstone. After this grouping of rocks experienced significant erosion, the flood basalt lavas erupted 183 million years ago, leaving near-vertical diabase intrusions at shallow depths. Today, the only surface exposures of the Karoo flood basalts can be found within Lesotho and a narrow adjacent region of South Africa. This region is largely 300 to 1,000 meters higher in elevation than the rest of the original exposures. As, during the last 182 million years, the region of Lesotho experienced less significant erosion while the rest of South Africa lost 1,000 meters thick of rock. This revealed layers of diabase which were previously buried a kilometer underground. Since this diabase was significantly harder than the surrounding sedimentary rocks, it eroded away at a significantly lower rate, causing pillars of these igneous rocks to seemingly appear from the ground as tall pillars. As a final note, I would like to thank @AnthonyLoconte7835 who won a contest I ran, as he made the closest guess to the value of gold within this container. He has a special message for one potential viewer. Congratulations to you, Tristan Loconte, his son, for seeing your first tornado and even capturing it on camera. Congratulations on your find, as witnessing extreme weather from a safe distance can be quite a treat. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.